And as people are learning to cope with staying home, they are turning to streaming services in droves like Netflix. One of the shows in the top 10 right now, a docuseries that came out in January called Pandemic, How to Prevent an Outbreak. We spoke with one of the executive producers, Dr. Ryan McGarry, about how they knew this was coming. And as an ER doctor here in LA County, what it's like being on the front lines of this pandemic.
I know you're a local ER doctor at USC's County Hospital. Can you just paint us a picture of what it's like right now on the front lines dealing with this coronavirus? Like, what is it like on a day-to-day basis in the ER?
I think that to call every ER doc and nurse you know right now an athlete is a reasonable comparison. No joke. Every ER doc and nurse out there should be taking care of themselves like an athlete, should be sleeping as well as they can be, eating and drinking well, because this is now a very physical job. I also would call out that one of the hardest jobs right now in Los Angeles is our ancillary staff and custodial crew. Can you imagine, you know, knowing that there's a likely exposure that's been brought into a room and now your job is to clean it? You know, that's a 2 to 3 hour clean. These are folks who probably don't make a lot of money. And wow, I mean, what a bunch of heroes right now rushing into that room so that they can reset it and we can treat another patient.
You know, that's such a good point. Also, I was wondering, how scared are you as a doctor? Because now we've seen some fatalities with doctors around the world. Even some ER doctors are more recently put in critical condition. You're in danger of that viral overload. Are you scared?
I think that, yes, of course, we're scared. I'm personally human. But at the same time, we went into a public hospital for a reason. We like the challenge. And I think we like knowing that we're part of the fabric of this city's public services. It's something that we're all very proud of. I know some of us wake up in the morning doing 100 push-ups to get ready for a shift. Some of us pray. There is, again, a true sort of athleticism to this, almost a battle readiness that I know is alive and well, particularly at my home hospital at LA County and Keck of USC, where, you know, I train there and I've spent my career in many ways really exploring how unique of a hospital it is there, and I'm so proud to be a part of it.
Okay, let's switch over to Pandemic. So I started watching it yesterday. It was absolutely fascinating, but I didn't realize this was filmed before the coronavirus. Tell me how you knew this was a possibility.
We didn't know. I mean, you know, and people keep asking us, did Netflix know? You know, we had a release date in January for almost a year prior to anyone's knowledge of this new virus. I think what it speaks to, and I think I can speak on behalf of my other executive producers here, is that 100 years ago, 1918, there was a very similar outbreak, the great influenza pandemic, that we started to look at and go, huh, if this were to happen again, would there be similarities and how would society respond? It turns out, as you're seeing, and I think that this is where, you know, maybe we did have some predictive value. You know, modern medicine only gets us so far when nature throws us a curveball like a novel virus. And I think that suddenly we started to realize, you know what, 100 years may not make that big of a difference. The fundamentals are still the same. Our healthcare system can only handle so much. Our immune systems can only handle so much. If you throw in a novel virus like this, all bets are off.
This vaccine could eradicate.
Thank you so much, Dr. McGarry. Pandemic, How to Prevent an Outbreak is on Netflix now. It is really good, like amazing at how accurate it is. And this, like he said, this is all created way before the pandemic we're experiencing now.